Thank you. Let's have a look.
Dead. Good.
This is the pool that thing came from. The parasite now writhing behind your eye. The casing is fragile. The slightest touch could cause it to crumble.
On my way. I'll give it a shot.
Images of goblins, their habits and histories flash into your mind. The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please, before they return! They return. The enemy! So many enemies!
Remove us
from this body!
From this case, free us.
You notice edema, a swelling of the brain causing pressure where it strains against the shell of the skull. The brain lifts from the skull, but you notice an opportunity. You could cripple the strange creature, making it more subservient, should it prove a threat.
Our freedom is ours, friend!
The creature pauses, listening. Something behind your eyes seizes in recognition.
To the helm!
The helm we are needed.
The brain tenses, as though querying an unseen advisor.
Do you not hear it? We will not survive here.
Your head throbs and your skin tingles. Visions rush past. A dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
My head. What is this? Squaw. You are no thrall. Vakith blesses me this day. Together, we might survive. Who am I? Your only chance of survival.
Fury. I am death.
If not over, then through.
Construction is too alien. Nothing looks familiar.
This
ship is crashing. Do you intend to die for a stranger?
Try that contraption next to the pod. They did something to it when they sealed me in. Hurry! Please!
The console appears dormant. The mechanisms are completely unrecognizable at first, but then you spy an empty socket. Nothing. The console remains dormant. A dazed woman is trapped inside the pod. She doesn't notice you. As you place your hand on the pod, you hear something. A presence connected to the pod, commanding the person inside to change. The console appears dormant. The console hums to life. But what is its purpose? Will it free the captive or transform her like that other unfortunate? Nothing in the appearance of the device betrays its purpose. It could do anything. It could even transform the occupant of the pod. Like what happened before. Suddenly, you feel a hideous squirming in your head. The parasite. Then discomfort fades, and another sensation. You. Connection. Authority. You feel the biomechanical brain of the console process your command and yield to it. A shiver runs across your mind. You feel sated. Into her thoughts. Her gratitude is mixed with wariness, because you have a Gith with you.
You keep dangerous company. Fair point. Looks like there's plenty of fighting ahead. Let me come with you. We can get off this ship and watch each other's backs along the way. Jennifer, one moment.
Finally. Let us make for the helm. We've wasted enough time already.
She's right. Lead on.
Faint images appear in your mind. A brain, a Githyanki warrior, and centuries of darkness.
Seems simple enough.
We're nearing the helm. Once inside, do as I say. Who put you in charge? I trust my own judgment. Kanyak.
I'll take this way.
Swift as my feet can carry me. Choice but to keep going. Breathe deep and move.
Victory awaits.
What should I do? On my way.
Oh!
Another fight. Let's go.
I'm Fury. Death.
Still on my feet. Wonder if the gods are watching me.
I will take my pick. Make way. To let up. Heading there.
Blood comes easy these days.
I will ascend. This'll do. Talk to me. On the move.
I wonder if this is worth the cost.
If the ship hits the ground, we're dead.
can't slow down.
Hurry, before they strike.
My way.
Best be on my way.
What's the plan?
What now?
Can't give up. Not now.
Time to push my luck again.
Time to strike.
Nothing important is ever easy. All right.
The Helm's alien trans... You've made it in time.
Thank you.
As you wake, the tadpole squirms in your skull. The chaos of the crash site confuses the landscape. You'll need to find a settlement or landmark, and you'll need to do it quickly. The tadpole is a death sentence, and the clock is ticking. You need a cure.